Good morning, students. In the last session, we have discussed fundamentals of object-oriented programming. In that, we have discussed what is object-oriented paradigm, difference between procedural and object-oriented programming, the concepts of object-oriented programming. In today's class, we will discuss introduction to Java. Java programming language, it is based on the principles of object-oriented programming. Java is one of the most widely used programming language today for developing various types of applications. So let's start with introduction to Java. Introduction to Java. Okay, contents. In today's session, we will discuss what is Java, Java history, Java milestones. So let's start with the first thing, what is Java? Java, as I've said, it is an object-oriented programming language. That is, it is based on the principles of object-oriented programming languages. It is a cross-platform language. Java is a cross-platform language. That simply means programs written in Java programming language can be executed on multiple different platforms. For example, if a program is written on Windows platform, the same program can be executed on any other platform, like it can be executed on Linux platform or Macintosh platform. Platform may refer to a software platform or a hardware. If we take an example of C programming language, which is not a platform independent programming language, a program written on a Windows platform in C programming language may not be directly executed on any other platform unless we compile it on that particular platform. So you may say the programs written in C programming language are not platform independent, but programs written in Java programming language are platform independent. Next, it is used for standalone applications, net-based programs, and to program consumer devices. As I've told you, today Java is used to develop many different types of application. It can be used to develop standalone applications for desktop systems. Net-based internet applications can be developed. Or even Java is used for consumer electronic devices such as cellular phones, PDAs, microwave ovens, mobiles, etc. Okay. Next, history of Java. Java, it is developed by Sun Microsystems of USA in the year 1991. Java was developed under the project named as Green Project, headed by James Gosling. So James Gosling is also called as father of Java programming language. Objective was to develop a software for embedding in consumer electronic devices. The original objective of Java programming language was to develop a software for consumer electronic devices like mobiles, PDAs, washing machines, microwave ovens, etc. The original intent of Java was not the computers. Initially, Java was called as Oak. Later on, it has been changed. There is a story behind the name Oak. It is said that there was an oak tree besides the office of Sun Microsystems, which was visible from their window. And looking at that particular tree, they got an idea of a name, Oak. There is one more story which says that oak is a symbol of strength and chosen as a national tree of many countries like USA, France, Germany, Romania, etc. And because of this, they have chosen the name Oak as the name for their programming language. Internet users had problems of portability and platform independence. At the same time when the Java emerged, there was one more technology which was taking shape, and that was World Wide Web. World Wide Web came on the internet in the year 1993, and the problem with the World Wide Web at that time was portability. There were thousands of computers connected to the internet sharing some resources. It may be programs, files, etc. A program written on one computer or for one platform may not be executed on other platform. So this issue is called as portability. So a program written on Windows platform, when it is executed on a Linux platform, it was throwing errors. And this is where Java found its way into internet. Java is portable cross-platform language. So programs developed in Java can be executed on multiple different platforms. So Java found its way into the internet. Using Java, Java applets were developed which were capable of running on different platforms. Initially, not all browsers were supporting Java applet, and that is the reason the Sun Microsystems developed their own browser called as Hot Java. Later on, the other browser vendors also announced their support for Java, renamed as Java in 1995. The original name of Java was Oak, but because of some legal issues, the name was again changed with a new name, that is Java. The name Oak was already registered by some other company, and that is the reason they had to change the name with Java in the year 1995. There is again a small story behind the name Java. It is said that James Gosling, along with his teammates, was having coffee near their office, and the name of the coffee was Java. And from that name, they got an idea. One of the employees suggested the name, that is Java. Again, there are many other stories for this. Okay, first public release, that is JDK 1.0, in the same year, the first public release of Java was JDK 1.0, where JDK stands for Java Development Kit. Okay, next, the Sun Microsystems was acquired by the Oracle Corporation in the 2010. Sun Microsystems developed Java, but Sun Microsystems was acquired by Oracle Incorporation in the year 2010. So today Java is part and parcel of Oracle Corporation. The current version of Java, as I am explaining, it is Java 14 or JDK 14, released on March 17th, 2020. Again, as you are listening to this, we may have a new version coming on the internet. Okay, next important thing, it is Java milestone. Okay, we have a column that is years, and we have progress of Java on the second column. So in 1990, Sun decided to develop software that could be used for electronic devices, and the project called Green Project, headed by James Gosling, was started. So they decided to develop a language for consumer electronic devices in the year 1990, and they announced a project. The project name is Green Project, and the head of the project was James Gosling. In 1991, the announcement of new language called Oak. So the language was developed, and they announced this language in the year 1992, the team verified the application of their new language to manage a list of home appliances using a handheld devices. So they tested their new software on handheld devices in the year 1993, the World Wide Web appeared on the internet and transformed the text-based interface into graphical-rich environment. As I told you, www came on the internet in the year 1993, and that changed the way the internet was before. The team developed a new web browser called Hot Java to locate and run applets in 1994. So Sun Microsystem developed their own browser in the year 1994. 1995, Oak was renamed to Java, as it did not survive the legal registration process. And in the same year, Netscape, Microsoft announced their support for Java. 1996, Java language is now famous for internet programming as well as general purpose object oriented programming language. In 1997, Sun released Java Development Kit 1.1. 1.0 was announced in 1995, whereas 1.1 JDK was announced in 1997. 1998, Sun releases Software Development Kit, that is SDK 1.2. Sun releases Java 2 Platform Standard Edition J2SC and Enterprise Edition J2W in 1999. They divided Java into different categories, that is J2SC, which included the basics of Java, J2W, which is advanced Java features like servlets, JSPs, JDBC, all these concepts have been included in J2EE, and one more, that is J2ME, that simply stands for Java 2 Mobile Edition for mobile applications. In 2000, J2SC with SDK 1.3 was released, and J2SC with SDK 1.4 was released in 2002, and so on. In 2003, 4, 5, the Java has evolved from 1990 till today, that is 2020. Okay, that's it for today's session.